Let me remind people that have forgotten their college grammar that first person perspective means the person who is speaking. Second person perspective means the person who is being spoken to. And third person perspective means the person or thing being spoken about. And the point is that spirit, or the ground of being, or ultimate reality, has been looked at through these three perspectives in major different traditions. And there's been arguments, fights, even wars over which is the correct way to look at spirit. And the answer is all three of them. So without experiencing what spirit is like in first and second and third, you're going to miss what it feels like when spirit starts coming down. And so most likely, if you are doing non-dual suchness in the Buddhist tradition, you will just experience it and interpret it as I amness. You'll call it just the first person. And you'll even, in some cases, derogatorily put down spirit in second person and go, oh, those theistic traditions, they don't know what they're talking about. Mm-hmm. That's because you haven't experienced the three faces of spirit. And so the three faces of spirit are what spirit looks like on the relative side of the street. It's when spirit first starts to manifest. And because the quadrants go all the way up and all the way down, as soon as Godhead or spirit or non-dual suchness manifests, it will manifest in I, we, and it, or pure I amness, pure I thou-ness, and pure I it-ness. And so experiencing all of those is necessary if you don't want to really lose track of what spirit feels like as it starts to manifest.